Hello everyone, welcome to SQL Repository. You're watching module number 2 of AWS CLI. In this video, we are going to create an IAM user using the user interface. And then in the next video, we will use this user to create another IAM user using the CLI. Okay, we need at least one IAM user to connect to AWS CLI, then only we can use AWS CLI. So first user we will have to create using the UI. So this is what we are going to do in this video. We will create a group and then we will attach policies to the group. By attaching policies to the group, we will be assigning permission to the group. And then we will create a user and that will be a programmatic access user. So it will have the access key. You will get to know about it more when I will create the user in the UI. And then I will set the permission for the user. And there are three ways to do that. First is add user to the group. I'm going to use that because I have already created the user by now. And then the another way is copy permission from existing user. So if you already have an user and you want to give the same permission to the new user, you can always do that using the option copy permission from existing user. Then the third and last option is attach existing policies directory. So if you can, actually AWS has too many policies created there already. So you can use those policies and attach those policies to the user and it will give the permissions to the user. So you can also do that, but we are not going to do that for this video, but I will just show you how exactly you can do it if you want to give the permission using the policy directly. So as I've already told you that this user, which will be a programmatic access user, it will have an AWS access key ID and secret key to connect. So let me go to the browser. AWS console page is already opened. So I will search for IAM and then select IAM. And once IAM page is open, the IAM management console is open, I will go ahead and create a group. So you can see the user groups here. Click on it. Click on create group. And then give a name to the group. So I will call it super admins. And then add users to the group. I don't want to add any user right now because I don't have any user. Then attach permissions policies. This is optional. But if you will not attach any policy, then this group will not have any permission. So I will go ahead and attach a policy here. So I will search for administrator access. So you have many policies here and you can select any of them based on your users. But I want to create the admin user. So I will select administrator access policy. Then scroll down, click on create group. Okay, so the group is created now. Now I will click on users here. I don't have any user right now. So I will click on add user. Then I will have to give a name to the user. So I will call it admin. Then you can also enable console access, but I'm not going to enable console access. I just want this user for the programmatic access. So that is fine for me. So I'm not going to select this. Click on next. Then as we have already discussed, there are three ways to assign permission to a user. First is add user to group. And we have already created a group. So we are going to use that. But there are other two options. One is copy permission from other user. So if you already have a user, then it must appear here and you can select that user and it will replicate the same permission to your new user. Okay. And the third option is attach policies directly. I've already attached the policy to the group, but if I don't want to use the group, then I can go ahead and attach the policy with the user. But it is not a good practice because, you know, if you want to give similar permissions to multiple users, then in that case, you can use the same group for all those users. And just suppose if you want to make the changes in permissions or anything as such for multiple people and they are attached to the same group, you can just go ahead and change the permission of the group. But if you are not using group and giving the individual permission to user, then you will have to edit each and every user, which is not a good practice. I don't have to assign the permission in that way because I have already created the group. So I will select this. Then I will select the group, click on next. Now I will click on create user. So my user should be created anytime now. Okay, so it is created, but there is no password or any other key for this user. So I cannot use this user right now. In order to make this user usable, I will have to select this user, edit this, then scroll down and you can see security credentials here, right? So click on this and you can create credentials in multiple ways. You can use MFA, you can create access keys and you can create passwords also, but I'm gonna use access key. So I will click on it. Then it is suggesting me that the best alternatives will be CLIs, local code, and there are many other options, but I'm not going to use those options right now. So I will select other and it says it is okay to use other options. Click on next and then just give a description tag value. So I would say access key for admin user and then click on create access key. Now the access key is created. So you can see the access key ID here and then the secret access key here. Okay, if you click on so, it will show you the access key. I'm not going to click on this. However, I will delete this user after this video and then you know, after creating another user using CLI. So this is fine for me, but this is this would be highly secured because if anyone will get these keys, they can access your AWS console. So keep it secret, keep it somewhere safe. Okay, so now I'm gonna copy this access key ID and open command prompt. And as I've already configured my Windows to use AWS CLI, AWS CLI is already installed here. So I'm gonna type AWS configure and it will ask me for the access key, the ID and the key, and then some other information, and then I will be connected. So earlier I had an access key, that is why it is showing me the old access key, but I've already deleted that. So I will provide new access key here. Oops, it is not the complete access key. I think I've copied it from here. So let me copy it again. Then pass the access key ID here. Then the secret, I will copy this, paste it here. Now the default reason, right now the default reason is EU Central 1, but if you want to change the reason, you can do it right here. And if you don't want to change it, then all the AWS CLI commands has the parameter for reason. So you can always go ahead and use that parameter. Then the output format. Default output format is JSON, but if you'll give text here, then you will get all the outputs in text format, but you can do this at the command level also. So I'm not gonna give anything here and I'm connected now. So just to verify if I'm connected or not, I'm gonna run AWS CLI command, which is AWS IAM, and then I would say list Okay, list policies will have too much of data, so I'm gonna discuss this later, but that's fine. Let me go ahead and execute this command, and it will give you all the policies, but that will be too many policies for this window, so you cannot view all of them together. If you'll keep on hitting enter, it will keep on showing you more policies, but you cannot see it here. But the whole purpose of running this command was to show that AWS CLI is configured, and using this IAM user, you are able to run AWS CLI commands. Okay, so this is what I wanted to cover in this video. In the next video, I will create another IAM user. So I will create the new group and the new IAM user using AWS CLI, and then for the rest of the videos, we will use the same user. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. I will see you again in the next video.